And I'm back. It's Wayne here with Daily Devotionals. And we're going into another chapter. It's the same story. We're looking at the story of Jesus as he's on the sermon that he's preaching on the Mount. Matthew chapter 7, verses 1 to 6. Judge not that you be not judged. Ho, that's a big one. There's a whole lot of judgmental people in this world, and there's a whole lot of judgmental people in the church. Jesus knew this, and he was speaking against it. Do not judge people unless you want to be judged. For with what judgment you judge, you will be judged. And with what measure you use, it will be measured back to you. Hey, unless you want to be judged, unless you want it to come back at you, and they have the same criteria on you, you better watch out. Judging, in terms of like, people would look at something like, well, that's a sinner, that person's lost, right? People do this type of judgment. Well, that's dangerous. There's only one judge, and that should be God. And Jesus gives a parable to kind of explain this. He says in this illustration, and why do you look at the speck that is in your brother's eye, but do not consider the plank that is in your own eye? Imagine that. Imagine if you had this big beam that is in your eye, and you're looking at some person. You're like, excuse me, sir. You got a little thing, a little sawdust there. Man, look at you. Look what's in your face. How can you say to your brother, let me remove the speck in your eye, and look, the plank is in your own eye? Hypocrite. First remove the plank from your own eye, then you will see clearly to remove the speck from your brother's eye. It's not saying that you can't help somebody out, but deal with your issues first. Sometimes we got more issues than other people. Sometimes the people that want to help out the most and correct people's sins are the people who got the most sin in their life. Remove the plank from your own eye before you remove the speck from somebody else. I remember going to Ripley's Believe It or Not. And in Ripley's Believe It or Not, there was this one room where it showed a picture and also showed a model, like a statue, like a wax model of a person. And this beam shot through the guy's eyeball. I mean, that's not funny, but hey, listen, it's funny in that if that person who had a beam that went through his eye from the car crash were to get up and say, excuse me, sir, can I help you out? Officer, ambulance worker, something's in your eye, can I help remove it? I think the guy has bigger problems than the speck of dust in somebody else's eye because he has something shooting through his face. Jesus says that's a hypocrite. First, deal with your issue before you try to help somebody else out. Do not give what is holy to dogs, nor cast your pearls before swine, lest they trample them under their feet and turn and tear you in pieces. You see, when a dog cannot appreciate holy things, pigs cannot appreciate jewelry and pearls, why give those things to them? Listen, if somebody is on your case and they're judging you, you know what? Don't pay them any mind. Don't waste your time casting your pearls before swine and giving something holy to dogs. This is a great verse. I mean, it sounds rough, but sometimes we have to stop wasting our time with certain people. Sometimes we're trying to help somebody out and they don't want to be helped. Don't cast your pearls before swine. Somebody who cannot appreciate what you're doing for them, don't give what is holy to a dog. Because what's going to happen? They might turn around, trample on what you've done for them unappreciatively, and try to hurt you instead. So listen, don't judge people. Deal with your own issues. And when you try to help somebody, listen, after dealing with your issues, you try to help somebody, only help people who can appreciate the help that you want to offer. Again, everybody, if you like this video, give us a thumbs up. That helps people to discover these videos. We want more people to learn about these videos so that we can spread the message of God to the world. YouTube is a great way to share God's message. So please subscribe and share. Click the share button. Share it on Facebook. Share it with your friends. Let other people know what is happening. If you were touched by this message, let somebody know. If somebody was judging you, maybe you want to share it in this video as well. Thank you, everybody, and we'll see you tomorrow.